Well, hello and welcome back to Confessors of Christ Church. My name's Tony Alonzo. I'm the pastor of C3, and I want to welcome you back to service this coming Sunday. That's right, this Sunday at 11:03 a.m. We will be flinging open the doors and welcome you back in to worship, to praise, to open up God's Word, and to continue gathering as believers, praying together, taking communion together, and worshiping our Lord and Savior. So this Sunday, we are welcoming you back. Now, the question that many have is, what can I expect as I come back to church this Sunday at Confessors of Christ Church? And we want to answer that for you right now. But before we get into all the details, I want to make sure it's abundantly clear that while we are opening our doors and inviting you to come back in and join and worship with us, it is not a requirement, and we do not want anyone to feel pressured or to feel ashamed if they do not come this Sunday. If you have health conditions that concern you, please do not come this Sunday. If you've experienced COVID-19 or have been exposed to it recently, we encourage you not to come. And if you are currently sick or not feeling very well, we also encourage you not to come this Sunday and invite you back as soon as you're able and you are ready to come back. With that being said, if you are able to and you are ready to come back, we want to give you an overview of what to expect as you join us again this Sunday at 11:03 a.m. First of all, as you walk in and as you come, you will see this trailer behind us in the entrance spot where you normally come in to the Four Corners Upper School. You'll park as you normally do. You'll walk in to where you normally walk in. You'll see the double doors that'll be open, but you will see something new. You're gonna see a table off to the side, and on this table, there will be hand sanitizer, there will be face masks, and there'll be individual bottles of water. Now, recently I saw a sign that said, "Love thy neighbor, sanitize thy hands." So we will have that available for you as you walk in to hand sanitize as you come in. There'll also be hand sanitization areas set up throughout the congregation for you to take advantage of anytime that you would like. If you don't have a face mask and would like one, we'll have those available for you as well. Now, face masks are not required for entrance. You will be able to come in, and if you choose not to wear a face mask, you are more than welcome to. CDC guidelines do not require them. However, if you would like to have a face mask and you would like to have one, we encourage you to have one, and we encourage you to come in with one, and we do not want you to feel uncomfortable at all. I will be having a face mask as I'm greeting, and I will take mine off for the preaching, and then once the service has ended, I will have mine back on again. But we encourage you to prayerfully consider on how you would like to handle that. Now, food and drinks in the hospitality table will not be available for this particular Sunday and for the next couple of Sundays as we will reevaluate each Sunday moving forward. So if you'd like to bring food or drink or something besides the water bottle, we encourage you to do that as well, and you would be welcome to bring any type of food or drink. If you bring something really good, like say a McDonald's value meal, feel free to bring your pastor one as well. Not required, just a suggestion. As we look through, we're going to have a new setup as you enter in as well. So gone is going to be the time where we would sit and face the video screen as you are maybe used to, but we are going to have a setup that is going to utilize the entire cafeteria so that we can practice social distancing during this time. So we will have the back wall that we have seen off to our left-hand side will now be the backdrop for our service. And we are going to do a half circle of seating all the way around. This will allow us to have plenty of room with plenty of space so that families can sit together, and those that want to sit together can, and those that would like some extra space will have that available for you as well. We will also not have our Bibles out because we're replacing those for the time being with worship guides. You'll receive a single-use worship guide as you come into the door, and on that we'll have the songs that we will be singing since we will not utilize a video stream during this time. It'll also have the Bible verses that we will be going over. It'll have the prayers that we will corporately be praying, and it'll have any announcements that we would like to share with you. And so those will be on the single-use worship guides. Now, Children's Church is going to be set up a little different. We're going to be utilizing the entire gymnasium for our Children's Church. And instead of the children sitting during the music portion, we're going to invite the children starting at 10:45 a.m. to make their way into the gymnasium to where they will be able to begin their time of play, their time of worship, and during their lesson time. We will have food and snacks for them, single-use water bottles, as well as a single-use snack available for our children as well. So when you come in, there will be a new table that'll be set up in front of the restroom area, which leads to the gymnasium. And there you will sign up your children and then we'll lead them into the gymnasium during that time. Now, should your children decide to stay in service, they'll be welcome to. And we encourage you as the parent to do what is best for your children. We will have a sermon packet designed just for them available as well. Many have asked about a live feed. If you would like to stay home during this time, being that we're coming in this Sunday only a couple hours before the start of the service, we're unaware if we're going to be able to have a live feed set up. Our goal is to do so, and if it is, it'll be set up on our Facebook page, which can be found at facebook.com/thisisc3. If we're unable to do so, we are still recording the sermon, and we'll have that up as soon as possible afterwards. Now, we're not expecting any infants during our first reopening. However, if you'd like to join us and you have an infant, we'd encourage you to please reach out, whether through email at tony@thisisc3.com or through Facebook, and we'd love to make sure that we have a team set aside and an area set aside to care well for your infants. Well, that is all of the information. If there is more that you would like to know or questions that come up, please feel free to send me an email at tony@thisisc3.com or comment if you're watching this on Facebook or YouTube below. And I look forward to getting back in touch. And we will see you this Sunday at 11:03 a.m. at the Four Corners Upper School. God bless and see you then.